Hello children, in this video we are going to learn about adjectives, degrees of comparison. These are the textual exercises in your lesson for A Wonderful Gift. So you all know what adjectives are. Adjectives are nothing but, these are the describing words that describe a noun or a pronoun. So I have a short video on adjectives, just have a quick glance on it children. Yes. Here is the video, I'm going to play it for you. Adjectives. Here you can see a mother and a daughter talking with each other. Can we order something to eat? I'm hungry. Of course, dear. Let's have a crisp dosa with some hot sambar. I will share yours, ma. I love dosa. But I will order a spicy chicken curry and rice. And for dessert, the colorful cassata with nuts. That looks enormous. Then I will share that, Shami. Oh no. Let's see what all the adjectives we have seen in this conversation. First, order adjectives. These are describing words. They tell more about the noun or a pronoun. Sometimes they can come before a noun. Example, crisp dosa, hot sambar, colorful cassata. If you notice, they have come before a noun, before dosa, before sambar, and before cassata. So these adjectives, we call them as attributive adjectives. When they come before a noun, we call them as attributive adjectives. And sometimes they can come after the noun or a pronoun and verb. For example, I'm hungry. That looks enormous. So when they come after a noun or a pronoun and a verb, we call them as predicative adjectives. Usually, adjectives describe the quality of something. It may be the color, the taste, and the appearance or the shape. For example, red, hot, hungry. These are the few examples of color and state. And state of being hungry. They can also describe the quantity. Quantity means how much, how many. It may be the number or the amount or the extent. For example, three, many, long. These are the few more examples of adjectives. So children, you have understood what exactly the adjectives are. When we talk about adjectives, we have 3 degrees of comparison in adjectives. You know, there are three degrees of comparison in adjectives. They are nothing but the positive degree, the comparative degree, and the superlative degree. So, if you can see my screen, you can see some pictures. See here. Can you see 3 pictures over here? Can you observe these pictures? One is bus and a train and an aeroplane. These three are the three different means of transport. So when we talk about bus, only a bus, how can we say that? Bus is a fast moving vehicle. So when we talk about only bus, it's a means of transport, we use positive degree. We describe the speed of the bus using the describing word fast. And second sentence, if you can see here, train is faster than the bus. Here we compare train, the speed of the train, with the bus. How can I say that? Train is faster than the bus. In the first sentence, the describing word fast has changed to faster than. In the second sentence, here the comparison is happening between the train and the bus. See the third sentence, aeroplane is the fastest moving vehicle. So when I compare the speed of aeroplane with bus and train, I use the superlative degree here. It is nothing but the fastest. So I can say that aeroplane is the fastest moving vehicle. It's coming to the next slide. In a nutshell, I can say we use positive degree to describe a person, a place, or a thing. It means only one person, one animal, or a place, or a thing. Here I gave you an example of Anna. Anna, I'm talking about only one girl. Anna is a good girl. So how do I describe Anna? I use the word good to describe Anna's nature. Let's see the next one. When we compare two persons, animals, or places or things, we use a comparative degree or comparative adjective. Usually, we can see the word THAN than in comparative degree. See here the example. Susan runs faster than Rima. Here the comparison is happening between Susan and Rima. So I use the word faster than. See the third one. When we compare three or more, we use a superlative adjective or superlative degree of comparison. Example, if you can see here, the giraffe is the tallest animal in the wild. When I compare giraffe's height with any other animal's height in the wildlife, it is the tallest animal in the whole wildlife. Yes or no, children? Yes. So here the comparison is happening between giraffe and rest of the wildlife, whether it may be a tiger, elephant, or whichever animal in the wildlife. So when comparison is happening among three or more than three, we use superlative degree. Now we have few examples of positive, comparative, and superlative degree, children. Just have a glance. Tall becomes taller and tallest in comparative and superlative respectively. Similarly, big becomes bigger and biggest, low, lower and lowest, hot, hotter and hottest, large, larger and largest, lovely, lovelier and loveliest, happy, happier and happiest. So these are the few examples of describing words in positive, comparative and superlative degree as well. So hope you all understood what exactly the adjectives are and degrees of comparison. Children, I would like to show my screen share and I'm going to send you an assignment form. I just want you on the same concept. I just want you to fill in the answers and send it back to me within the given time. Thank you all. Happy learning. See you all in the next video. Bye, children.